Puis plantez, j'ai pas fait tester. J'ai pu m'arriver à faire une certaine expérience. Ok. As we celebrated the 30th anniversary of the Egyptian IVF Center, I would say 20 years ago in 1999, the genetic laboratory established in the Egyptian IVF Center to be the first and the sole genetic laboratory inside IVF Center in Egypt and maybe in the Middle East at that time. Pre-implantation genetic testing, PGT, pre-implantation genetic testing is defined as the testing of pre-implantation stage embryos for genetic defects. It has been developed for couples whose potential offspring are at risk of severe Mendelian disorders, structural chromosome abnormalities, or mitochondrial disorders. Pre-implantation embryo testing requires IVF in vitro fertilization, embryo biopsy, and either using fluorescent in situ hybridization or polymerase chain reaction at a single cell stage. Our policy of PGT is using the current time for screening the patient undergoing the IVF ECSI, searching for chromosomal abnormalities, and using hemoglobin electrophoresis to the patient searching for beta thalassemia. The abnormal patient comes for PGD, for chromosomal translocation or numerical abnormalities. If one partner of them is a carrier of translocation, in beta thalassemia, both partners are carrier of beta thalassemia. Families with thalassemia serving, families with other non-genetic diseases. For karyotyping, this is the technique of karyotype, heparinized peripheral blood culture for short-term culture, 72 hours. After 72 hours, harvesting to collect the cells and spreading on microscopic slide. Staining with a mixture of trypsin, enzyme, and chemistry. This is the G-banded metabase spread. After that, the metabase spread is processed by an image analysis system with a karyotype to form karyotype set. So this is a karyotype, G-banded karyotype with trisomy 21. This is normal karyotype. If XX is a female, if XY it is a male. In 2006, we have the biggest database of patients undergoing ECSI all over the world with 5,300 patients from 1999 to 2019, we screened 50,040 patients. Of them, 6,884 couples. 14,730 patients and 1,246 with severe male factor. We found 430 patients of abnormal with 2.8% of the patients. In all the investigated couples, only one of the partner carried a chromosomal aberration main ratio constituted the majority of the Arab nationalities with 83%, 342 patients, while the female constituted the remaining 17%, 71 patients. These chromosomal aberrations include 259 cases, about 2% of sex chromosome abnormalities, while 0.8% had autosomal aberration. This is the chromosomal abnormalities detected in the male paratron. 83% of the abnormalities, chromosomal abnormalities detected in female partner, 17%. This is a karyotype with XXX syndrome. This is a karyotype with deletion Y, inversion Y, duplication Y, and this is a karyotype with Robertsonian translocation 13-14. This image shows fluorescent insight to hybridization fish technique to confirm the results of the karyotype using different types of probes. Single cell diagnosis, either using fluorescent insight to hybridization, analyze chromosomes, sexing for X-linked disease, searching for chromosome abnormalities, improving IVF success rates, especially in aneuploidy, polymerase chain reaction, analyze specific mutation, single gene effect, fish testing, analyze chromosomes, sexing for X-linked disease, chromosome abnormality searching, translocation, Robertsonian translocation, this is only for acrocentric chromosomes 13, 14, 15, 21, and 22, reciprocal translocations, insertions, inversions, linked chromosomes. This is a karyotype also of 13, 14 translocation. This translocation may result in plateau syndrome in office brain, in 5-13, and also may result in uniparental diphony 14. When we do BGD on the second cell, the red signals, this is the telomere of chromosome 13. The green signals, this is the RB1 gene to confirm that's 13, and the aqua signal is chromosome 14. In this cell, this is a balanced patient, a balanced embryo carrying a 13-14 translocation. The limitation of this technique, it does not differentiate between the balanced carrier and the normal embryo. This is normal for chromosome 13 and 14, also may be balanced, may be normal. This is monosomy 14, this may lead to abortion. BGD for reciprocal translocation, we use the same strategy. Here we use telomere of chromosome 11Q. We use the telomere of chromosome 22, sorry. The first picture is normal or carrier balanced. The second is partial trisomy 22. This is sexing embryos for BGD, fish analysis on interface nuclei. This is normal female with normal 221 chromosome, no Down syndrome. And this is normal male with normal bare of 21 chromosome, no Down syndrome. Results of VGT using fish for chromosomal anomalies. The Egyptian IVF center, 140 cycles started, 110 proceeded to VGD, 105 80 cycles, clinical pregnancy 40, 36.4% in miscarriage, 35 babies born, and the first baby delivered in 2003. VGD single gene defects, the most common and the problematic one is beta thalassemia. Screening for beta thalassemia patient undergoing IVF ECSI. Patient screened 11,973 cases with high hemoglobin HbA2, 490, 22 cases in which both partners are carrier, cases with sickle cell anemia, 116. This is a diagram showing abnormal hemoglobin pattern with hemoglobin electrophoresis. Beta thalassemia is the most common chronic hemolytic anemia in Egypt. It is estimated that 7 per 9,000 births annually are affected. Beta thalassemia is an autosomal recessive disorder with over 200 different beta globin gene mutations. In Egypt, the most common mutations are IBAS1-110, IBAS1-6, IBAS1-1, CD37, CD6, and CD39. VGT cases done in the Egyptian IVF Center, IBAS1-6, IBAS2-1, IBAS1-110, IBAS2-745, IBAS2-842, CD5, CD6, and CD39. Our working protocol takes VGT for beta thalassemia. Mutation detection for most parents and affected the child using reverse long lot hybridization. Confirming the mutation with real-time PCR. Genetic testing of single blastome, single cell whole genome DNA amplification by RepliG single cell kit. Mutation detection by real-time PCR. This is an example of case. Both partners have the mutation, IBAS1-110. They natural conception, they have affected child by PGT. They have two embryos, only carrier the mutation IBAS1-110. Results of PGD for beta thalassemia, number of cycles 45, embryo transmitted cases 43, clinical pregnancy 16, miscarriage 3, babies born 15. HLA typing was done for 18 patients. Array comparative genomic hybridization, array CGH. Pre-implantation genetic screening, the incidence of chromosomal aneuploidies increases proportionally with women's age. More than 50% of embryos naturally conceived or generated by IVF are lost before birth and mostly before implantation. Chromosomal aneuploidy is the major cause of implantation failure and pregnancy loss. In more rare cases, they cause abnormal pregnancy and life loss. Embryos generated in vitro كانت جيناتيكال تيستد بيفور ريتيرن تو ذا وومن ذا اوترس فور بلاند سكريننج اند فور انبلويد بوري تو ترانسفير هاز بين شون تو ديليفر سيجنيفيكانت امبروفمنت ان اي في اف كلينيكال اوتكم. Which technique? The observation cannot discriminate between chromosomally normal and chromosomally abnormal oocytes or embryos. FISH allowed to test only few chromosomes per time. PCR is used to test specific region of known diseases or few chromosomes at maximum. A RACGH enable identification of chromosome abnormalities by making thousands of independent measurements for each chromosome, even in DNA from single cell. Whole genome spotted on a slide or microchip, fluorescent analysis for each locus, high resolution analysis on the whole genome in a single experiment. Here is a test DNA from the sample, labeled with green, reference normal DNA, labeled with red, human genomic DNA spotted on the slide, bacterial artificial chromosome, or synthesized in situ on the slide, oligonucleotide. The ratio of the emission of the two dyes in each spot is related to the copy quantity of each locus to see copy number variation of test DNA respect to the control DNA. Advantages. A RACGH reveal imbalances in copy number, reforms thousand fish simultaneously, high resolution, high diagnostic potential, allow to test all the chromosomes in a single experiment, easy to set and implant, the interpretation is software guided. Re-implantation genetic screening, VGS, using array comparative genomic hybridization, RACGH, allows selection of embryos with normal karyotype before embryo transfer. A RACGH experience of the Egyptian IVF Center, 105 cycles for 101 patients underwent plasmid biopsy, and 96 fresh transfer cycles were performed. The indication of this patient were repeated IVF failure, repeated pregnancy loss, previous history of unemployment of sperm, and unemployment and unemployment screening and sex selection. The maternal ages ranged from 25 to 42 years. Results. The scanned array was processed and scanned by laser scanner and processed by a special software of RACGH. The software calculates the ratio between the emission of two dyes and generate the result as in the picture. Half of chromosomes in green, it means the duplication. Number of chromosomes in red, it means deletion. Here, there is duplication 16, 21, deletion of monosomy in A and Y. A RACGH experience of the Egyptian IVF Center, number of cycles 105. Embryo transfer 96, clinical pregnancy 48, 50% of the transferred embryos,
this country is old, there is more 25. Our result shows that a legacy GH has the potential to provide high pregnancy and delivery rates after transfer of employed embryos. My sincere thanks to all family members of the Egyptian IVF Center. Thank you.